Hi guys, and welcome back to another IBRACORP video. Thanks for coming back and tuning in with us today. We hope you've been enjoying the content we've been putting out recently. It's been very busy, and we've been putting out as much as we possibly can on different subjects that our members have been suggesting, which has been really, really good. If you would like to make suggestions for future videos, need help, or want to help support the channel, feel free to subscribe to our website, subscribe here on YouTube, and then join up into the Discord. We've got plenty of members in there who have some knowledge that they're happy to share and help those that are struggling, including myself. So if you're interested, all the links are down below in the description. For today's video, we're going to be covering Overseerr, which is a request management application. It's free and open source. It's still pretty new, and at the moment it's considered in beta, but by now you've probably heard of it or you've seen it around here and there. And it's meant to be similar in the sense of application like ombi. It's pretty clean. I think a lot of people will appreciate the style that it's been designed with, as well as the integrations with Plex, making it a very, very smooth experience for those wanting to try something a little bit different for their quest management software. So if you're interested, you want to give it a try, or you just want to know more, stay tuned and we'll get stuck into it. Alright guys, so welcome back. We haven't really covered requesting software too much here on the channel yet. So Overseerr is an application that's currently in beta. I've used it as a secondary request system for my members and the feedback has been good. There are some features that I wish it did have, but I'll cover those as we go. So here we are on the main website, which is overseerr.dev, that's E-E-R-R. And as you can see, we've got a nice screenshot here of what it basically looks like. It allows you to request TV shows and movies. One of the things I really like about the application is the built-in recommendation and suggestions system. So, you know, if you don't know what to pick, you don't know what you want to watch, it's got those recommendations built in there with integrations with Rotten Tomatoes so that you can see all sorts of reviews and things like that. So it kind of moves us towards a more in-depth request system. Rather than someone just going in there, typing in something and clicking request, it can actually be a more of a user experience where they come in, they might browse a little bit, stay around, see what they find. If they like something, then they can request it. So it allows them to have a little bit more of a experience, if you will, when using the application, which I really like. It's very easy to request stuff. We will get into this, of course. Here's a quick snapshot of what that looks like. So you can put a request through individual seasons, individual episodes. If you're using a server you want to run it on, you've got the option there. And here's some of their highlights. So easy request management. Okay, we've covered that, beautiful. Granular permissions, also very important when you have a large user base or member base and you want to restrict certain things to different people. Now that's pretty standard, but as long as it's providing us that here, that's a very important feature. DVR integration. So it's fully integrated with applications like Radarr and Sonarr, and it supports activity monitoring within Overseerr itself. Now that's pretty cool because rather than just sending the job off to Sonarr and Radarr, you can actually track it as well. It has 4K support. It can scan your Plex library. So this is a big tick here for Overseerr. Notifications, the agents included are email, Discord, push bullet, pushover, Slack, and Telegram. So very, very useful. You can have it hooked up to your Discord server. The mobile-friendly experience looks great on mobile. No argument there. And you can apply limits to requests. So in case you're wondering, here's a couple of FAQs before we get started. It's got multiple languages. You can create local users. So if you don't want to have to rely on Plex, you can just create local users that can log in directly to the app. It supports all the new and old Plex TV agents and movie agents. It has full support for anime agents as well. As we already know, it will allow it to use your Radarr and Sonarr, and you can import your Plex users. And of course, you've got the installation and documentation here. As always, I would like to highly recommend that if you enjoy something that we show here on the channel and you want to help support the developers, please always go to the links that I put up in the description or in the video and show your support for the developer. This is free and open source, so someone or some people are taking time to make this. And if you like it, help support the project. They're offering something really, really cool for no money. So that's pretty much the overview, guys. Pretty straightforward. Let's just get into the install and we'll start it up and we'll run a end-to-end request and we'll see how that looks. So we've logged into our server. We're here on our main server, Zeus, today. And the reason why is because I've already got all the media automation stuff set up. I've covered a little bit of that in one of our previous videos, was the view torrent, as well as the atomic moves and hard linking video, which we showed you a little bit more in depth with Sonarr and Radarr settings. So the first thing we're gonna do is head over to our app store. If you don't have the app store, I have a video showing how to do that. So now that we're in the app store, just go ahead and search for Overseerr. You'll see it pop up here in the autocomplete, and we have multiple different options to pick from. Pretty straightforward. Now, there's a couple of options. I'm gonna go for the hot IO option, or Hoshio as I like to call him. I think we've become friends now, so I'm just gonna keep calling him Hoshio until he corrects me otherwise. Go ahead and click install and click on default. Now, I've got option here that always turns on advanced view. You may not need that, so we'll just flick that back to basic view. We've got our networks. We wanna pick our custom network here so we can have them all talk to each other and we can have them using their host names. You'll see that we have the pre-configured section here for your app data config. It goes to config. Now, the sections that we don't see, however, are our media library, and we need to map that ourselves. So let's go ahead and click add another path porter variable. We'll call it a path, and we'll just call this media. In the container path, we're just going to call this slash media. We're just going to go ahead and call that media, and then we'll map that here in our server to where we have all of our stuff, so our media folder, and then we can pretty much have that map there. Now, if you haven't watched my last video, which was about using hard links and atomic moves, I suggest you do watch that video. It's very important to the reason why we have these paths. Okay, we've moved away from the whole separate shares for movie, TV, etc. We want things to load instantly, so it's really beneficial for you to watch that video before you continue. Once we've mapped that, we can go ahead and click add, and that's pretty much ready. That's really all we need to set up. Of course, make sure your port is free, 5055. If I was to go show all Docker allocation and we go control F, we type in 5055, I can see that it's not being used anywhere else in here. So we've got all the information, go ahead and click apply and click done. Now, if we head back to our Docker tab and we'll scroll right down, you can see I've got Overseerr here now. So we'll left click and click open in web UI. So now we're in the main web UI. So we basically have to get set up. So the first thing you'll do is sign into your Plex account. Okay, I've just clicked sign in with Plex. I already had my Plex signed in. So now it allows me to just continue basically. So we'll click refresh here so they can try and retrieve our server by itself. Drop down the list. If you see your server in there, I'm going to pick the local address so that it can talk locally to our Plex server. What we don't really want is for this application to reach out to the internet to get to Plex and then back down again. So I'm going to pick the local address. I've just picked it from the list. It shows up as local. It's got the default host address that I've set it up with and the port that I've set it up with as well. Do we want to enable SSL? I'm not going to because I don't actually have SSL on local. If I was coming in through the net and it was through the reverse proxy, then I would enable it. So go ahead and click save. Gives us a nice tick up here that tells us that the connection is successful. Scroll down a little further and it basically wants to know your library. So if we just click sync libraries, there's our two libraries. Go ahead and tick yes and yes. How easy is that so far? Pretty straightforward. And now it basically wants to have our scan done. Now it can do it in about 24 hours. Or we can just start it ourselves. So we'll just go ahead and click start scan, and it's going to go ahead and start scanning our library. Now we don't have to wait for that. We can just continue with the setup. So go ahead and click continue. Now we want to basically set up our Radarr and our Sonarr. So let's go ahead and start with Radarr. We'll say it's the default server for movies. We don't have 4K. We'll go ahead and click 4K as well, and we'll start the server name. So we'll just call it Radarr. Now this, the benefit of this, we'll just call that Radarr. Now the benefit of this is if you have multiple Radarr applications or instances running, you might want to give them different names. I've only got the one, so I'm just going to call it Radarr. Put in the IP address. So this is the IP address of the server which Radarr is running on. So I can see the port here is already there. We'll put 7878. We don't need to put SSL, but it does want us to give the API key. So let's go to Radarr, go ahead to settings, go to general, and then you can see your API key. So we'll copy that and paste the API key in here. For the base URL, we don't have one configured. Once we've got all that information in there, we should be able to connect to it. So let's go ahead and click test. And now it's grabbed some more information from us. In the quality profile, select the profile that you've got configured. The root folder, which is pulling from Radarr settings, that's correct. And the minimum availability. So you can have people request stuff that has been announced and maybe it's 3 years away or only in cinemas, only released, etc., etc. So I'm gonna go ahead and say announced. I don't mind stuff being in there for a while. With our tags, we don't have any tags set up, so we don't have to worry about that. If we want a external URL, we have an external URL, but do we want to put it in here? Not really, because I just want people to use the request service and not go directly to Radarr. But if you did, you could just set that yourself. So then we'll click enable scan, and that way it can communicate with Radarr and scan what Radarr has in its library as well. And that's about it. So if we just click test, everything seems right, go ahead and click add server. And you can see I've just got a warning here that's saying if you only have one server and you've ticked it for both 4K and non-4K, they should not be designated as the same thing. So I'm actually going to go ahead and edit that, and I'm going to untick 4K. Click save. But if you did want 4K, it's asking you to basically set it up as a separate server. And now we're going to repeat the whole step over again for the Sonarr. So there's our Sonarr and Radarr setup. Pretty straightforward. That was really easy. And we'll go ahead and click finish setup. Now it's going to start loading up, and you know, we're away and going. So that's working, which is awesome. So in order for us to test this now, we really need to request something. Before we do that though, I'll just take you through the interface and we'll have a look through all the settings. So let's say over here we've got recently added, so it's already picked up stuff that's been recently added to my server. Looks really good. You've got recent requests, obviously there's none, we've just set this up now. But here's the great thing, if we come down you can have a look at what's trending. So what are other people watching at the moment? You know, have a look, maybe something interests you, you might want to check it out. You know, it looks really good, no worries. Scroll down a little further, you've got genres you can go through as well, which is really cool. You've got the ability to search by studio, you've got popular series, so stuff that's ranking high in the ratings, and then you've got networks as well. Now, I should note as well that this is in beta. So guys, anything you see here that may not look correct, may not look right, it's probably still being worked on. And if you would like to help contribute to feedback, make sure you go check out the GitHub page by clicking this link. So if we come down to requests now, this is the request interface. We can see that this is where requests would be. We don't have any. Then we've got users, and here's me, here's my little self. And then we've got settings. So in the settings, you've got your API keys and your application URL. Now, if we're going to reverse proxy this, now's the time to do it. So we'll go ahead and type our address. Now, I've already covered this in the nginx proxy manager video. So if you're interested in finding out how to reverse proxy something, please watch that one. This is assuming you already have. So that's our external URL. So we can go ahead and click save changes there. So some other settings that we've got as well, we've got our enable proxy support. So if you have a proxy that you need to get through, you can configure that here. You can set external API access to read only, so if you want it to be a little bit more secure in that sense. Hide available media, you can tick that. Allow partial series requests, so if somebody wants to request a series, do you want them to grab just one part of it, or do they have to grab the entire series? So that's a nice function as well. In our users settings, we've got enable local sign in, so that if you want to set up users, you can do that. The default permissions they have when they do join, whether they have auto approval, anything like that. You can also set the limits as well. Then you've got your Plex settings. So we've gone through this when we actually set it up. So nothing too crazy there. Head over to services. That's where you configure your Radarr and Sonarr, which we've already done. You can then configure your notification settings. So if you wanted to set up emails, this is where you'll put your host name. I've made a video with Gmail on how to use that if you want to use it for free. There's other options out there as well. If you wanted to use Discord, this is where you would set up your Discord. So you can have an avatar URL, the username of the bot, the webhook. So in Discord, go to server settings, integrations, webhooks, then you create one and you just put the URL in here, and you can put what messages you want the bot to send out. It's pretty similar for the rest of them. So you've got all these other ones here as well, including webhook itself. Then you've got the logs, so you can monitor what's happening. So you can see it's really nice and clean, really easy to read. Any jobs that are currently running or have run or scheduled to run are in here as well. Then if you go to about, you've got your time zone, your version, any other information that you might need. So let's test an end-to-end here. So let's go ahead and request something. So I'm going to request the movie that isn't currently available. So you can see with the tick here, we've got it available already. So let's go ahead with something that isn't currently available. Let's say this one here, the marksman, that looks interesting. We'll click on it. You can see as it loads up, it's giving us a nice overview. It's giving us the blurb. We've got reviews. You know, even how much it costs to make the movie. I mean, I don't know how much information you need, but it's got it there. Easily watch a trailer if you like. You've also got an options here on the side, so you can see whether someone's already requested it or not. And we'll scroll down. You can see another similar titles. Maybe you saw something that you liked. So look, I'm happy with that. Let's say I want to request it. We'll go ahead and click request. It's going to give you some options here. And for me, because I'm the admin, it's approved automatically, so we don't have to worry too much about that. We don't have any tags, the user that I'm signing in as, the destination server, the quality profile, and the root folder. So I don't really have to change any of that because we've all set it up when we added our Radarr server. So we can pretty much just go ahead and click request. So that says it's requested successfully. We'll go back to Radarr now. So in Radarr, we can see that it did put the request through and the search began, and I basically added it to our queue. So from here, we can see that the request does work, and it looks quite clean when you're looking at the request like this as well. At any point under requests, we can go ahead and delete it, or we can just go through and see what it is that the person has requested. As you can see, we've refreshed the page now and it's showing as processing. So it is actually currently processing and we'll be able to see how it's going. You can see here recent requests, looks really good as well. Comes up there for you, so it's on the main page for everyone to see. If someone wants to sign in, they can see that it's already been requested as well. So that should help cut down on the double ups that you see a lot of the time. It doesn't have to be overcomplicated, you know, it's meant to be nice and easy to use, very friendly to use, and on mobile, it's very mobile friendly. When you go to open this up on your phone, if you're reverse proxying as well, it should look really, really good. So I hope you enjoyed that, guys. It's a really neat little application. I think it's really worth checking out if you're interested. If you have a request system that you are currently using, you want to try a new one. If you have a preference for a different one or you have the suggestion to try a different one, drop it in the comments down below and we'll get around to checking it out. We've also got a video request channel in our Discord, so you can put anything that in there that you might think you'd like to see a video about. I hope that helps. Feel free to check it out. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. It really helps the channel out. And I appreciate every single one of you for continuing to support us and our work. We hope you have a nice day and we'll see you in the next IBRACORP video.